Aftermath is the story of a British officer stationed to Hamburg at the end of the Second World War. He invites his British wife over. She comes across to Hamburg, super hating Germans. She lost her child and she can't bear them. And unbeknownst to her, her British husband has allowed a German family to stay in the house that they're moving into and allows them to move up into the attic. And you can imagine her negativity about that. And it's really the story of how she goes from that to a story of great understanding and empathy. Keira Knightley was the first one to commit to the film. She was amazing. She loved it. She thought the script was sensational. And then Alexander Skarsgård, I think knowing Keira was doing it, was like, okay, yeah, yeah. And then Jason Clarke came a bit later. We wanted to get, funny enough, it was like we wanted to get the British wife and the German first. It sort of somehow felt, once we had that dynamic, then the British officer would fit in. We had lots of really challenging moments. I suppose one of the moments was shooting the scene where there's an attack on the car that they're in, and it was shot very late at night. It was minus 15, and I had to ask Keira Knightley to run down a slope that steep in a ball gown and stilettos. And I had no idea that that was the biggest insurance risk a director could ever take. And afterwards she said, because I really like you, James, I did that. It was like, I must have been crazy to ask her to do that. I think Keira Knightley is absolutely perfect for the role of Rachel because she combines what she wanted, which was quite a slightly cool exterior at the beginning of the film, because that's her character. And yet, as the film unravels, she becomes tender and empathic and open to what she's placed herself in, which is this alien environment that she has no knowledge of the language, the house, the servants, and the devastating ruins that she sees.
Of course, alongside her, you have two of the finest male performers of their generation in Jason and Alexander. Can you talk about each of them? Because I think there's very different performances from each of them, but very vitally important for the overall balance of the film.
Yeah, it's incredibly important that Alexander Skarsgård and Jason Clarke had yin and yang, if you like, because they had... Stefan Lubert, the German, has to offer her something sufficiently different from her husband to tempt her away. And I think that's what Alexander has, because he's got a kind of gentleness. And Jason, who's amazing, has kind of more alpha in a way, and he's more raw as Lewis is. And remember that Lewis, her husband, has gone through the war, 5 years of conflict. So he would have come out of that conflict with post-traumatic stress disorder, really. I always start with the human. You know, I think people are going to relate to the human. And then you can weave as much political or symbolic in as you can get away with. I mean, I am quite a political person. But this story has a political message. You know, at a time of great nationalism, this is a story against nationalism. Whichever side of the divide you're on, whichever side of the divide in America you're on, this story should appeal to anyone who wants a kind of salutary reminder that we need to be responsible for our actions, and we need to work towards something that's a damn sight more positive than the direction we seem to be going at the moment.
And obviously with period drama, you also have the challenge of recreating a moment and a unique location in history. Can you talk a little bit about the production challenges for this one?
Yeah, well, we were lucky enough to shoot half this film in Prague, where all the big ruins were done. Not that Prague's full of ruins, but there was a big empty ruined sugar factory nearby. And then, so that gave us the groundwork in order to create these massive ruins. And then on the other side, we have Hamburg, which has this beautiful interior, this house that was totally authentic, and we just needed to decorate it.
When audiences walk out at the end of this film, is there one thing in particular that you're hoping they are thinking or feeling at the end of that experience?
I'm hoping people will walk out with the power of a love story, but also with the universal message of reconciliation, compassion, and forgiveness. And we all in our lives will have our own personal aftermath of our own, whether it's the loss of our parents or some tragedy. And this is a lesson that actually, give it time, walk towards anybody who's close to you, and you will find the support and succor that you need in order to move on in your life.
Talking about moving on, I know you're moving on to another great project with, I believe, Richard Gere, is it? Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, I've just finished a big drama, come out on the BBC, Mother, Father, Son, with Richard Gere and Sarah Lancashire. That is going to be on your screens also the beginning of March.
Why should people not be missing that? What can they expect if they tune in for that in March?
Mother, Father, Son's an amazing psycho thriller about a family and about corruption in politics and the media. And Richard Gere's phenomenal.